Hello student, this is Dr. Priya Deshpande from MCA department of ISMR Negri. I welcome you all to time series analysis video lecture series. So let's start. Today we are going to see what is the introduction and meaning of time series, which are the different components of time series, what is the analysis of time series, which are the models used for analysis of time series, what is the use and utility of time series analysis, and finally, which are the measurements of trend. Basically, time series means collection of statistical data recorded over a period of time, either daily, weekly, monthly, quarterly, yearly, or in any specific time interval in chronological order. Here, collection of data in chronological order is very important. That constitutes a time series. Then, this time series is nothing but we can say that analysis of history or past data to predict for the future values of the variable under study. Usually we assume that the future predictions are based on the past pattern of the values of the data and that study is important to understand the pattern and recognize the pattern and to predict for the future values so that we can predict about the profit or loss in the business world. The typical example of time series are simply daily prices of shares, or we can see the daily prices of gold, then weekly sale of an item in departmental store or malls, then monthly deposit or withdrawals in a bank, or we can say that monthly consumption of electricity of a particular family, and yearly production of vehicle of a certain company, then daily record of maximum and minimum temperature at a particular place, then population of a specific country at census years. And nowadays we are having a lockdown period, and which is due to the pandemic of COVID-19. So number of new cases of COVID-19 infection in a city on a daily basis is nothing but the best example of time series. According to Spiegel, the time series is defined as the values y1, y2, y3, so on up to yn of variable y taken at different time intervals t1, t2, t3 and so on up to tn. Basically, time series is always a function of time. So it is always denoted by y is equal to f of t, where y is dependent variable and the time t is always an independent variable. The general notation of the time series is given in the table. We have seen that time series is a function of time and it has four major components, and the components of time series are: first one is trend, which is denoted by capital T; second one is seasonal variation, which is denoted by capital S; third one is cyclic variation, denoted by capital C; and the fourth one is irregular variation, which is denoted by capital R. These variations are having fluctuation in the time series and plays very important role in time series analysis. In time series, it may happen that any one may be present in it, or sometimes all four components are present in a time series. So let us see the components of this time series one by one in detail. The first component of time series is trend. It is also called a secular trend. It is a general tendency of the data observed in the given interval of time. Trends are always smooth, regular, and having long-term movement in the data. Trends may go upward or downward, or it may remain same. It means that the value of the variable may increase or decrease, or it may remain same. Time series generally oscillates around the trend. There are two types of trends: linear trend and non-linear trend. The best example of time series showing trend are yearly prices of the commodity, yearly birth rate of a country, then monthly budget or monthly electricity or petrol consumption of a family, daily prices of gold and share. Second important component of time series is seasonal variations. This seasonal variation causes fluctuation which repeats every year or after some specific period of time. The best example of seasonal variation is sale of raincoats in the rainy season. It is highest during June and July of every year. Sale of luxurious item increases during the festival seasons. We know that the sale of cloths and the other luxurious items is increases during Diwali festival, Christmas festival and the other important festivals. Another example is traffic is maximum during rush hours or office hours. Here, the season may be any time interval. It may be a year, month, a day, a week, an hour or any specific time interval. Sometimes it may be seconds too. If we see the growth in bacteria, then the season may be seconds or minutes too. Important factors which are responsible for seasonal variations are climate changes, then festivals, then change in fashion or habits of customers, then change in government policies and strategies. Generally, seasonal variations period is of 1 year, or we can say that the seasonal variations reoccurs generally once in a year. The study of seasonal variation is useful in marketing and business study to understand the future demand and price of the commodities. Then it is useful in planning of financial arrangements and mostly in preventive maintenance or management of all areas. The third important component of time series is cyclical variation. The cyclical variation causes fluctuation which repeats over a time period of 1 year. The cyclical variations may not be necessarily uniform in periods. The amplitude of variation also changes from cycle to cycle. That is, period of variation may also changes from cycle to cycle. The cyclical variations are typically observed in business worlds. And commonly, the cycle of cyclical variation may be of 7 to 10 years. The phases of the cyclical variation are, first is prosperity, or it is also known as boom. Then second phase is recession, third phase is depression, and again the fourth phase is recovery. So these four phases are generally observed in period of 7 to 10 years. Now, which are the factors causing cyclical variations? Generally, the business cycles, the imbalance in economy, then availability of loans, export and import policies of a country, and the facilities available for export and import, then automation and business competition, or we can say that the technological changes in the business world, then inflation, and the last one is overdevelopment of the business. The fourth and last component of time series is irregular or erratic variations. These variations are unpredictable in nature. One cannot predict before the variation occurs in the business world. The result of these unforeseen forces or abnormal events create a great variation in the values of the variable in time series. These do not follow any specific pattern. Which are the factors responsible for irregular variations? Generally, these are the natural calamities like earthquake, flood, pandemic. We can take the example of COVID-19. It has downed the economy of the entire world. So we can say that the COVID-19 pandemic is the irregular variation in the economy. Then we can have abnormalities like war, strike and lockouts, which causes changes in the values of the variables. Sometimes this irregular variation mix up with seasonal and cyclical variations and creates great loss to the economy of the country. Sometimes this loss may be minor in magnitude, otherwise it is huge to the economy. It occurs due to unknown resources, so it is very difficult to isolate and analyze these irregular variations. We have seen the four important components of time series which causes fluctuation in the values of the variable. So let us understand the analysis of time series and the purpose of analysis of time series. Basically, there are two purposes of analysis of time series. First one is identification of the component which causes changes in the values of the variable. And second one is isolation, study and measurement of each component independently so that we can prepare a proper action plan to avoid the future losses. Basically, there are two models for analysis of time series. First one is additive model. Here we assume that all the four components, that is trend, seasonal variation, cyclical variation and irregular variation, are acting independently on the time series, and The total effect is sum of all these four components. So here we can say that the time series y is simply sum of all four components, that is y is equal to t plus s plus c plus I. The another model for analysis of time series is multiplicative model. Here the basic assumption is that all these four components are interactive and they are causing the changes in the values of the variable combinedly, and therefore the total effect of all these four components on the time series is the product of all four components. So here we can define the model as y is equal to t into s into c into I. Students, up till now we have seen the four important components of time series and the two models which are used for analysis of time series. Now let us see the use of analysis of time series. We use the time series study to describe the past behavior of the variable to predict for the future values. We study the past behavior so that we can get the idea about the pattern of the customers or maybe the patterns of the fashion the people are following, and then we can have a future prediction model for getting more profit in future. Sometimes we are interested to know the rate of growth due to technological or economical development, and accordingly we can the business world or the company or the organization can make their business plans. Sometimes it is necessary to study the change in the import and export policies led by the government so that the companies can have their different strategy planning for the production. Sometimes it is useful to study the comparison between expected and actual values of the variable to understand whether the predictive models are useful for the future study or not. In decision making, in strategy planning, in inventory management, and in sales and purchase departments, we generally study the time series. Up till now, we have seen the use of analysis of time series. So let us understand the different measurement methods for measurement of all these four components of time series. There are basically four methods which are used for measurement of trend. First one is graphical method. Second one is method of semi-averages. Third one is method of moving averages. And the fourth one is method of least square. Dear student, all these methods we will see one by one in next video lecture series. Till then, thank you. If you have any queries, please write to me at priyadeshpande06@gmail.com.